Let me just explain slightly about pantomime. In the program, it tells you what pantomime is. Yeah? It's a typical English story. It is funny. It involves audience participation. There's a villain in a pantomime, Abenaza. And when he comes on, you can shout, right? That was not very good. When Abenaza comes on, you can shout, right? He's a villain. And when the hero comes on, who is Aladdin, you can shout. Okay. And there's plenty of feedback, plenty of connection, plenty of participation. He's behind you. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, no, he's not. Oh, yes, he is. All right, I hope you enjoy the show. Oh, just one thing. We've just had, about half an hour ago, one of our principal players has dropped out for certain reasons, so you might well see one of the players having to read from a script. It's unfortunate, but it should still be funny. Hope you enjoy it.
Make way for the mighty ruler of the Chinese people.
This is Emperor and the Empress.
Pray silence for the Emperor's proclamation. The mighty ruler of the Chinese people has decreed a public holiday.
Hooray!
A short holiday!
Hooray!
There will be party at the palace.
Hooray! But you aren't invited.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclamation that his only daughter, Princess Martini, is fabulous and has come of age, we will shortly get married.
Hooray!
But not to me.
Woo! The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that his only daughter, Princess Martini, can marry any man she chooses.
Hooray! Provided he's fabulously rich.
The celebrations will last all week.
Hooray!
But we will have to clear up.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that the pubs will be open all day.
Hooray!
But they won't sell beer.
Hooray! They'll give it away.
Hooray! From a limited stock.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that there will be a parade of beautiful ladies in the street.
Hooray! I'm fully closed!
Hear the proclamation of the mighty rulers of the Chinese people and rejoice!
Ooh!
doing here, Wanton? They're stopping all the traffic.
I don't know. I suppose they want another bridge across the river.
Wanton, I'm nearly at the end of my search.
Oh, thank you goodness for that. My kid are killing me.
Not yet, Wanton. There's no time to rest yet. I did not travel the world in order to rest. Think of the dreadful places we have been to.
Oh, it's the Ranga Hotel.
I have found the whereabouts of a boy, an innocent boy. The innocent boy who can enter the forbidden cave. The boy who can obtain for me the lamp that will make the most powerful man in the world. Excuse me?
What about me?
You! You'd be no good. Wanton, you're not a boy, and you're no longer innocent.
That's not what I mean. It's all very well you beat the most powerful man as well. What about me?
Wanton, you are expendable. This is the place. Kindly bruise your knuckles on the door.
Okay. Hello, what do you want?
Is this Widow Twanky's Chinese laundry?
Yes, but we closed today for stock taking. Who are you and what do you want?
I am Abanaza.
A banana?
Abanaza, I didn't travel the way, half the way around the world to be insulted by a half-witted oaf with soap suds for brains.
No, who did you want to be insulted by?
I don't want to be insulted.
Who's your friend? I'm Wanton. You don't look that heavy.
No, she's called Wanton because she's always getting in the soup. I want to talk to the washerwoman.
You want the washerwoman? Why didn't you say? Mother!
What is it?
There's a man at the door says he's a banana.
Well, tell me to fill up and I'll be down in a minute.
Did you say mother? Widow Twankey is your mother, but you are not Aladdin.
Oh, no, I am Wishiwashi. Aladdin is my little brother.
Ah, your little brother, I see. I did not realize that my brother had two sons.
Your brother?
Well, I thought you was a banana. This one doesn't look at all fruity to me. Now get indoors and make yourself useful.
Madam, I'm afraid I've been rude to your esteemed elder son. I took him for someone who worked here.
Fair chance.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Abanaza, the brother of your late husband.
Then, how come I never met you?
From the earliest days of your courtship, I lived in a cell in a Tibetan monastery, engaged in deep studies of the mystic arts. Now I have returned to make the acquaintance of you and your delightful family. I am particularly interested in meeting your younger son, Aladdin.
It's good for nothing! Whatever do you mean? Whatever do you want to meet him for?
I have a job for which I believe he's uniquely suited.
Oh, don't be ridiculous! The boy hasn't done a stroke of work in his life! What could you want with a lazy lad like him?
My mystical arts have revealed that he has hidden talents. Talents I can use to good and profitable effects.
Profitable? Oh, there is money in it? But I couldn't possibly release this sweet boy. His wife would put the work on the laundry.
It would not take long, and the boy could be well rewarded for his efforts.
No, I couldn't possibly entertain him leaving my side for a single minute. He's far too precious to me. Not for any reward. How long would it take?
It will take a matter of a couple of days to reach my goal.
Two whole days deprived of my darling young son. I think my heart would break if he left me for that long.
Tell me about
the reward.
Ah, I see that money is of interest to you, my good woman.
No, it's not for me. It's for the benefit of my poor sons. I have saved up for a new washing machine.
Why? What happened to the old one?
Thieves broke and stole it.
Were these washing machine thieves caught?
They made
bereft of my tools of my trade. I desperately need money to finance a new washing machine.
Esteemed sister-in-law, you are clearly a woman of the world. Know then that the quest I wish your son to undertake will lead him to a cave filled with unimaginable riches. However, you and I know that money keeps the world turning.
I walk all day, I walk all night to pay the bills I have to pay.
Ain't it sad?
And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me.
That's too bad.
In my dreams I have a plan. If I could be a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work all life for the rest I have before.
A dragon on now, but never mind, we'll just ad-lib.
Ah!
beautiful.
A real stunner.
I wish I could meet you. It's no good even thinking about it. It will be impossible for someone like you.
I bet I could if I tried. How? She's surrounded by soldiers and courtiers.
Well, if you can create a bit of diversion, I will write in and shut her up.
Well, what will you say to her?
I'll get her around the city, show her the local sights.
The hanging gardens of Atrau Hotel.
Well, I'll improvise. I'm sure to think of something. Here they come. The problem is, how am I going to get her on? She hasn't got on the household cavalry, the finest guardsmen in the land.
Listen to me. With a little help from my friends, I will lose them.
Okay.
Double-glazing salesmen. Where are the good burgers of the city?
I said it already. They're at TGI Fridays.
Not that sort of burger. Don't you think it's the most horrid city?
Well, I kind of like it. I live here.
Here? But everything is so depressingly ugly. Oh, even the people. I'm used to beautiful clothes, beautiful buildings, and beautiful birds. Where is the good part of the city? Where is the people who know about important things like clothes?
As a matter of fact, my family business deals with clothes.
Perfect. Then you can show me the area where you live.
I would be delighted. Please step this way, hi. I see that must have been a success. Aladdin has disappeared, and so has the princess. Excuse me, have you seen my brother?
I'm sorry, I don't know your brother. Have you seen Princess Martini?
That's all right, I don't know Princess Martini either.
But she's the daughter of the emperor, everybody knows her.
Oh, that Princess Martini! I think she's gone for a stroll with my brother Aladdin. Do you really know her?
Yes, I am Tini, your lady-in-waiting. I was following her through the city, but I got bored, and now I lost her, and I feel so lonely.
You mean you live at the palace with the princess? That must be really grand. The most exotic place I ever visited was Anwar Supermarket. Where have you been with the princess?
Last summer, we went to India to Maharaja. He had a pool in the middle of his palace where all the ladies went swimming.
Why didn't the men go swimming?
Well, the Maharaja's elephants had run off with their trunks.
Okay, tell me about the princess. What's she like?
Well, like a princess, someone who used to live in the palace, wearing beautiful clothes and having her own mind.
You don't sound very happy.
Yes, it's so wonderful, I know, but I don't have any real friends.
Is it really that bad?
Thank you.
I could show you around the city.
Would you? That would be very kind, but I really must find the princess.
Well, I thought Aladdin, I'd meet him by the palace wall. With a bit of luck, he walk and we can meet with the princess. So let's go.
It's not fair! You rodent, deceitful fraud!
What did I do?
You told me your family were in closing business.
Well, yeah, I just showed you my mother's shop.
But I thought you meant your family designing delightful dresses for debut debutants. You must take me home at once.
Certainly, Your Royal Highness. Would you like to go straight to the palace, or shall we try to find the household cavalry?
Oh, household cavalry! I forgot about them. How jolly! Mother will be furious when she finds out they've lost me.
I could hide you in a wash basket.
You know, you're quite resourceful. In fact, I could quite get to like you. If you were a resourceful, good-for-nothing, restful son of a filthy washerwoman who I'm never going to speak to again.
Washerwomen are usually quite clean. And in any case, you haven't spoken to her yet. So it would be difficult never speaking to her again.
It's you I'm never going to speak to again.
Well, you're not making a very good job of it so far. It's this way to pass.
Like this. Where does this rock dwell?
I'm not selling.
Tell me at once.
Shallant.
Why ever not? We must send a soldier to fetch him.
But they'll be rude and nasty and pinch his arms. I don't want them to hurt him. He's really ever so sweet. Come on, Timmy. Let's go and find Mother.
the Empress, of course. In those days, we used to call her flat packet queen. Very flat. Was she so thin? Thin! I've seen more meat on the butcher's pencil. The princess has a beautiful eyes. Unlike her mother, I've seen better looking eyes than a potato. As a matter of fact, she had one glass eye.
How did you find out about it?
Oh, it came out in conversation. The princess has a beautiful complexion. And like her mother at all, I've seen better skin on a rice pudding.
The emperor is holding an audience at the palace. They need to bring a gift to impress you. I intend to be there.
You?
You?
Yes, I intend to marry the princess.
But what happened? Gift you will give for them while the all were clean.
I was hoping to impress her with my love for her. Then she'll go out and seek my fortune in the great wide world.
In that case, perhaps you would care to reconsider my offer.
Uncle Abanaza?
Come with me, Aladdin, and your future will be secure.
Could we get back in time for the ceremony at the palace?
That may be possible. However, it is imperative that we start now.
I don't know. I don't like the idea of being away from home.
Oh, go on and big sissy!
Should I go with him?
Yes!
Yes!
Mother, do you think I should go?
Aladdin, dear boy, you are so very precious to me. I don't know how I would manage with you going away. Have you got your toothbrush?
Yes.
Oh. Then it's high time you wear off.
Come, Aladdin. Come, Wanton. It is time that we hit the road.
Oh, what do you want to hit it for? It never did you any harm.
Goodbye, Wishwash. Goodbye, Mother. See you soon.
You know what passes me? I remember that Father said he was an only child.
Yes, he was. He had no brothers or sisters to play with.
But if he was an only child, how can Abanaza be his brother?
Aladdin is where you will do your work.
I certainly come into a cave,
but this is just a stone wall.
Nevertheless, this is the place. You forgot my magic wand, and this is the entrance to the cave, but it is shut. To open it, we only need to speak the magic word.
Who is it?
Open the sesame! Your job, Aladdin, is to go into this cave.
But I don't like caves. They're dreadfully dark.
In the cave, there is a lamp.
Wouldn't it be better to take a lamp into the cave?
It looks like an ordinary lamp when it is standing on a pedestal stool, surrounded by dazzling jewels and ancient stones.
So does Aladdin Mick Jagger.
Right. Your job is to find that lamp and bring it back to me.
But I don't want to go into the cave. It's dark and creepy and full of horrible, hideous things.
It comes down to a simple question, dear Aladdin. Which are you more afraid of? That cave or me?
Why I should be afraid of you? You're my uncle.
If you don't go, I shall give you one reason to be afraid of me. Remember that I have studied the mystic arts. My spells are deadly. Still, I shall see you come to no harm in the cave. Here, take this ring. It is a magic ring. It will protect you. Now into the cave and get me the lamp. Part of the spell of the cave. If he carries the lamp out, it will be his. He must hand the lamp to me. Then I shall seal him in the cave for eternity.
They are going to shut me in. What can I do? I have to persuade them to let me out. Uncle Abanasa! Uncle Abanasa, give me a hand! You'll have to pull me out!
Pass me the lamp, then I'll pull you out!
No, you'll need to pull me out! The lamp is too heavy to pass to you!
Nonsense, boy! Give me the lamp!
Shall I give him the lamp?
No!
You shan't have it till I'm out of the cave!
If you don't give me the lamp, you'll never get out of the cave!
But you don't want to let me out if I do give you the lamp! I heard what you said to one time!
You shouldn't listen to other people's conversations! You've clearly got the wrong idea! Now give me the lamp!
Never!
I'm not... Why are you so mean to me? I'm not your uncle, you stupid boy! Give me the lamp!
Never!
Then I'll show you in the cave! You'll never escape!
That's what you think!
This is your last chance, boy! Will you give me the lamp?
Never! You rotten, dishonest, scheming, evil villain! And you're not even my uncle!
Then I shall seal the cave, and you in the cave forever! Shut Sesame!
I'm shut in, but escape should be easy. All I have to do to get out is to say the magic word. Now, what was it? Can you remember?
Open Sesame!
That's it! But it didn't work. The rock should have opened. Perhaps you can't work the magic. I'll try. Open Sesame! Open Sesame! Nothing happened. I'm trapped. Trapped in this cave forever! No good. I've been wandering around here for hours, and there is no way out. I'm stuck in here with only horrible operations for company. What can I do? Perhaps the skeletons could help me. Oh, that's no good. If they knew the way out, they'd have got out while they were still alive. What's this? Oh, it's the ring Abanasa gave me. He said it was magic. What should I do with it to make the magic work?
Drop the ring.
Hey, it's getting hot. It's nearly burning my finger.
Also, look, you look like a nice boy.
Who are you?
You don't know? Don't you recognize the cultured manner? The exquisite cut of these clothes? The manicured nails? The air of mystery and magic?
You are Barack Obama's wife?
You don't recognize me?
No, sorry, who are you?
I'm her, I'm grieved, I'm Ethan.
Who is he? He is what? Him? Nah.
Yes.
He isn't.
Yes.
Oh, no, he isn't.
Oh, yes.
He is?
Yes.
Are you Genie?
Oh, you do recognize me. That's right. I am Genie of the Ring.
What do you mean?
Genies
are huge and muscular.
Well, not all of us. Some of us quite delicate. Anywhere your wish is my command.
What do you mean? Do you not have unlimited powers? Can I wish for anything I want?
Well, not unlimited. I'm not the powerful great genie of the lamp. For a start, I can give you only 3 wishes.
But all I need to do is to wish for you to fetch me the genie of the lamp, and I can have anything I want.
No, that's against the rule. I can't tell you about the genie of the lamp, but I can take you to him, and I can fetch him to you. The lamp hidden in a dark, forbidden cave, rather like this one. It's standing on a pedestal, surrounded by gels, rather like this one. It can be obtained by an innocent boy, rather like you. It looking just like an old brass, old lamp, rather like one you're holding. That's it.
This lamp contains the most powerful genie in the world. That's why Abanaza was so keen to get his hands on it.
Put it away quick. You might disturb the genie. He's hideout. He's horrible.
Oh dear. I wish you could get me out of this cave.
Why didn't you say? That's dead easy. All you have to do is go back the way you come.
But Abanaza has shut the entrance.
All you have to do is to say the magic words.
I tried open sesame, but it didn't work.
Open sesame, it's to get you in. Going out is the reverse of going in. So all you have to do is to say reverse of the open sesame.
Which is?
Emice Snapple. Try it.
Emice Snapple!
Try it with a bit more conviction. Well, you're going to need a helping hand. Will you give him a hand?
Yes!
Will you?
Yes!
That's right. The magic words are Emice Snapple. Say it by count on the three. One, two, three.
Emice Snapple!
The earth moved for me too.
We're now invisible for 10 minutes, thank you.
What's the word on the street, Wonton?
Oh, it's an old princess. I think he's on her way through the town.
Shall we mingle with the crowds, Wonton? We may learn something profitable. Remember, we need to finance the next phase of my campaign to capture the lamp.
She must be here somewhere.
It's no good, Aladdin. We'll never find her in this crowd.
Look, there is a post, Inspector Chu. Let us see.
Chu and me.
Yes, we want Chu. We want you to find out, Mother. Have you seen her? Have you seen a lady with a lamp?
Solas, I am today. I begin. For princess. Mustache.
Mustache?
Yes, mustache.
Now, what do we do?
Ha! It's him!
It's who?
It's me!
It's you? Shall we go?
Now's the time!
Here they come! So let's scram!
Inspector, do you know where I might seek that boy? The one who could cause all this trouble. It's very important that I find him. He's somewhere in the crowd.
How will I recognize him? You all look the same to me.
Yes, you're right. Yeah. His name is Aladdin.
And his mother is with the Twenkie.
Ah, yes, strange boy. He said his mother was Florence a Nightingale.
Florence Nightingale.
Yes, he said he was following with the lady with the lamp.
The lamp, Wonton. Would you Twankie has it? If we're quick, I can turn this to my advantage.
It's no good. I've been looking round town all morning, and there is not a soul willing to buy this useless old lamp. All the traders of the city are too excited about the ceremonies at the palace.
That's extraordinary. There must be something wrong with my hearing. I'm sure he said that new lamps for old.
Oh, yes. New lamps are old.
What's the catch? Is it part exchange? Do I have to buy life insurance? Or will he try to sell me encyclopedias?
There is no catch. He has found a market for old Chinese lamps.
I say peddler!
What does he do
with the money? What does he do with the money?
He buys a new Chinese lamps.
I say peddler.
New lamps for old. And I say profit. Might I offer you a fine new lamp in exchange for an old lamp? Do you by any chance have an old lamp for sale?
I do have old lamp, but it's very valuable. A family heirloom. I'm not sure that I could be to part with it.
Might I see it? Do you by any chance have this lamp with you?
Yes. Well, as a matter of fact, I have, but it's very valuable.
It has a hallmark.
It has a hallmark on it.
Let me see. Yes. Here's the hallmark. It says, that's a real museum.
Well, I should be exchange it.
Well, here you are. Take this new lamp home, where I'm sure you'll be enlightened.
What a strange man!
Ah, 20.
Ah, 2!
Bless you. I met your sons in the town today. They were looking for you, and the strange man was chasing after Aladdin.
That boy always being chased by a strange man. I can't think why.
I must disperse this crowd. Move along. Move along. Move along.
Mother, I found your dress. Have you seen Aladdin?
What are you doing here, you disobedient lazy boy? You were supposed to be at home, finishing my day's work.
We came to look for you. Aladdin wanted his lamp back. Now I lost him.
Silly boy! I suppose now we'll have to look for Aladdin.
The good idea would be for me to take this lamp home.
Why not go and find your brother?
Then you still got the lamp?
Yes. Well, no. I still have a lamp. Very valuable lamp.
What did he give you for the 30-year-old lamp?
Oh, that man!
A new pocket lamp.
He pinched my bottom!
Hey, you, come back my mother's bottom!
Stupid boy! Champagne, years of donuts, enamel chair, new shoes, new corsets, and a new washing machine!
No.
What?
No.
Please!
No. Mother, it was your suggestion. I'm going to use this diamond to win the hand of the princess.
But then they'll be gone! I'll never see them again!
What does a handful of old rocks matter compared to my love for the princess?
If they don't matter to you, I'll have them!
No, mother. My mind is made up. I'm going to the palace and you're coming with me.
Me?
And wishy-washy, I shall need an escort. Go and put on your finest clothes.
But what about my hair? I can't do a thing with it.
You could stuff a mattress with it. Go and put on your finest clothes. Do the best you can. I ran. I'm off to the palace to win the hand of the princess.
In those clothes?
What's wrong with them?
Well, I have seen better, Shashlik. You need something with a bit more wow and a little less phew.
Well, I wish you could make me fit to visit the palace.
A spot of dressmaking, just up my street. Come with me, Anna.
Is Marcus of Polo.
He must be worth a man.
He'll never take my breath away.
Next!
The next tutor is Oil Sheikh, who made his fortune selling dairy products.
Oh, wealthy Sheikh?
What did your name was?
I said Sheikh Yabuti.
What do you expect from an oil sheikh?
Next!
I bumped into a banana outside. How
another?
Yes, him. He's coming this way.
Before he sees you, it's your turn next.
The next suitor is this young gentleman. Your Majesties, may I present Aladdin?
You! You not right to be here! You're just a washerwoman's son! I'm not going to marry you! I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful. Go away! I never want to see you again!
Oh, mighty ruler of the Chinese people! No gift could ever match the beauty of your daughter. I feel ashamed to bring such feeble riches into her presence. Nevertheless, behold, I present you with that in the hope of winning her hand.
If I were you, you have a second thought.
He looks rather dishy, and his diamonds are lovely.
Perhaps you could marry him first, then have him boiled in oil. That's what I did with my first husband.
Make way, make way! The mighty Abenazer!
What do you mean by besting like this?
I bring you the wealth of the glittering cave, O midgety ruler of the Chinese people!
What stallion jewels?
And what an ugly face!
Have a care, my sweet Martini! I am the greatest sorcerer the world has ever seen! Your innocence could get you into trouble.
Leave it here alone, Abenazer! You deceitful, scheming villain.
But I have brought the greatest gift. I have won the hand of the princess and intend to take her away with me.
I shall stop you if I can, Abenazer. You won't get her away if I had anything to do with it.
Then you won't have anything to do with it. Not here, frozen ship!
You can't do that, Abenazer. I'm the emperor and that's one of my servants. You can just come in and praise jolly good fellow.
Oh, can't I? Who's to stop me, oh six-inch ruler of the Chinese people, when I can freeze you all? I thought not. Come, my dear. I shall take you away to my palace.
Abenazer's gone, and he's taken Princess Martini,
and he's taken Timmy.
It's far, far more than that. He's taken the diamonds.
I must go and rescue her.
I'm coming too. I must rescue Timmy.
Right, let's go.
Let's go, Mother.
Bravo.
The one Abenazer was after!
That lamp!
Where is it? Mother! Where is my lamp?
That old lamp! I was a peddler who was swapping new lamps for old.
The peddler! It must have been Abenazer! That's how he got all those jewels! And that's how he gave the power to free me! He's got the lamp! I must find you! Martini, knife now!
Personally, I could deal with a steep vodka!
Mother, this is not the time! The prince is in terrible danger!
Where are you going to look?
Oh no! I hadn't thought of that! What shall I do?
Run the ring!
Run the ring!
Run the ring!
Yes, the ring! I must summon the genie! It's getting hot again!
Oh, hello. It was number three. Is we're going to set me free, remember? It's not far. Nobody ever grant me wishes. I'm going to go off and sulk.
I'm sorry, genie, but this is an emergency. Abenazer has kidnapped the princess!
And I suppose you are going to wish for a heroic rescue instead of wishing to set me free?
Could you ask them? Oh dear, we need the lamp, but Abenazer's stolen it!
What? Abenazer's got control of the genie of the lamp? Why didn't he say? That's dreadful! How can I help?
Well, we don't know where they've gone.
Oh, that's that easy. Abanaza got control on the edge of the Gobi desert.
How will you get there?
Most people go by camel.
I'm not going by camel! They always give me the help!
I've got to get there fast, but how can I get there and set you free?
It's impossible, but never mind. Getting the lamp away from Abanaza is far more important. Let's go!
But you haven't solved the transport problem yet!
The great powerful genie of the lamp could whisk a magic carpet to fly all the way to Abanaza's palace.
And you can't do that? I wish you could help me rescue the princess, but how will you get me there?
That's it! Take him to Abanaza's palace. Well, you can't say I didn't warn them.
But what about me? I do have a quest. I want those jewels back.
Well, what do you expect me to do about it?
Taxi! Follow that cab! I want to say that. Hey, come back!
Martini are buying health.
Well, I expect we're being locked up with that developed thing like those diamonds. With a bit of luck, we'll find them as well.
And if we find the diamonds, we don't find the girls?
And the diamonds also. Wishy-washy! Do you get the feeling we're being locked?
Well, there are some signs of life there.
No! I meant back there, something moved!
You've been overdoing it. You're beginning to imagine things.
Did something move?
Yes!
Where?
Behind us!
Oh, no, it didn't.
Oh, yes, it did.
Come on, wishy-washy! Wishy-washy! We're being locked up with this basket!
That's the trouble with having a professional mother. Even when we go away, she brings her work with her.
No, I didn't bring it. It's my worst nightmare. I'm being locked up with unwashed socks.
What shall we do?
Personally, I'm going to do my Olympic freeze impression.
I can see a sea of happy faces.
What about Kozuku?
The coast is clear.
That's
sounded like Mother and Mishulash. But I couldn't be sure. It might be some trick of Abanaza. Where are we?
A sort of hall. Some sort of hall. The place for entertaining of the crowd of people.
Well, that will have to wait till later. I can hear a voice from behind this wall. And there's a window to the next room.
Well, sneak a peek.
I can't see.
I could do with that.
I could just see with a couple of exchanges.
It's one of the things my master have fished for.
I think there's someone coming this way. It's time to scupper it.
Return to normal as soon as we get married, my pretty princess.
But I'm not going to marry you. You're old and ugly. I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful.
No, two out of four isn't bad.
We'll
get married as soon as the priest has a free Saturday.
You can't force her to marry you. The emperor will object. You can't defy the mighty rule of the Chinese people.
The mighty tape measure of the Chinese people will do what I tell him. You forget, whoever you are, insolent Ting Ming, that I am the most powerful sorcerer in the world has ever known. Have a care, I will turn you into a beetle.
Oh, I will also send Paul McCartney.
Well, I'm not going to marry you. I shan't! Shan't, shan't, shan't!
Well, we'll see, my petulant princess. Perhaps a spell in the dungeon will soften you up. Guards, take her away! Okay, go off that way then. Yeah, that's fine.
What do you want to marry her for anyway?
Well, aside from the incidental trivia, such as a stunning good looks, if I marry her, I will automatically inherit the Chinese Empire when her father dies, which he will very soon. So, with the Empire in the bag, I can turn my attention to the rest of the world.
It's ridiculous. All you want to do is to build your own little palaces all over the place.
I want power, son. I intend to be the most powerful man in the world!
Wasn't fair. While you're seducing princesses and accumulating all this power, what's in it for me?
The pleasure of witnessing my rise to the top.
What gives me that any pleasure?
I've told you before, Wonton. It's because we are friends.
Why should we be friends? I've done a lot of things to help you. You haven't ever done to help anything to help me.
But I've never needed to. You're so resourceful, Wonton. But if there comes a time when you need me, I'll be there.
Times and bad times, I'll be on your side.
Now then, Walter, I have a crucial job for you. I want you to instigate a search of the palace.
You lost your false teeth?
No, Wanton. I want you to search for intruders.
Intruders?
Yes, Wanton. I feel that there are spies abroad. It is the most important that we protect the princess. Guard her well. Or with your life, if necessary. I shall retire to my room for a bit of intense thinking. I always think better lying down.
I've lost my bearings completely.
Shh. Wolves have ears.
Right. You try that way, I'll try this way.
Well, I never thought that I would do that at my age. I didn't find any diamonds, but look. I did find Aladdin's lamp. We'd better get away from here before Abanaz wakes up again.
Was Abanaz there?
Yes. He was lying on his bed, surrounded by very tempting bottles of champagne.
And you couldn't resist the temptation.
Quite right. I picked up an exquisite magnum of champagne. I hit him over the head with it.
Everyone thinks I'm one.
Huh. I thought you'd be an intruder.
I forgot to look out for intruders.
No, I'm never an intruder. I'm just so of discretion. Why are you looking for intruders?
Well, look, Abraham thinks they'll be looking for Princess Martini. But I don't so. How is so wild?
How are you looking down that way? I spotted some charity characters there earlier on.
Oh, thank you. I go and check.
Aladdin! The princess is in the dungeon. And all we have to do is to cut the case.
Right, where is it?
Abanaz has got it.
Oh, well, that should be easy then.
You forget it, my magic spells. I am still good for some short spells. Walk that way.
Perhaps he will defrost and come and rescue.
Certainly, he couldn't possibly. He's just a washerwoman's son. Rescuing princess is reserved for noble, honorable, rich young men. Such a pity, he really looked rather dishing. It's a shame that Abanaza has froze his assets.
Would you like to marry Jardin?
Certainly not. He's a poor weakling. I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful.
Well, 2 out of 4 isn't bad.
You may be right. And I'd rather settle for Aladdin than Abanazas. I really shouldn't have been so mean to him. He'd be a fool to want to rescue me after the way I treated him.
He was decent.
He was gallant, decent, and brave, and all I did was call him names. But now he just forget about me and look for more deserving princes.
I'm sure Aladdin won't forget you, not after what he said at the court.
Why is your cheerful, Ting Ming? We're stuck in this dump forever. Nobody's going to come and rescue us.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to keep our spirits up.
Ting Ming, I'm sorry. I really am. I'm so dreadful for people all the time. It's because I'm used to everyone doing what I tell them. But now it's different. I need friends and I really need help.
Terrible headache. It seems to emanate from this lump on my head. I can't think how it got there. I know champagne goes to my head. But it doesn't often leave lumps there. Now then, I must decide what to do with the princess. I have a hunch. Ah, it's you.
Oh, so it is.
But if you're here, that miserable wretch Aladdin may be here too. Take me to him. I have him in my power.
He's round there.
Where? Oi!
I think we've lost him.
And they're still going to kiss.
Aladdin! Thank goodness you are here! I was so worried when I couldn't find you in the palace! I had palpitations just thinking about what that nasty Abanazi might do if he found you in the palace! Where are they?
They're in the dungeon.
Why does he keep the diamonds?
His diamonds in the dungeon.
His diamonds. Not the diamond, the gun.
We've got the keys. We run away to rescue them.
Oh, if you must, the dungeons are just down here.
Let's go. But look out for Abanazi. He was following behind us.
Oh, behind us?
Yes.
Just group around and see what you can find.
It's abstract, it's abysmal, it's abandoned, it's abnormal, it's absurd, it's abominable, it's abominable!
How delightful, and you have the keys to my dungeons too. How convenient. I have you in my power. This time you are doomed!
I've escaped from you once and I'll do it again!
Escape from here? You'd have more chance of escaping from La Cabana Bar. Guards! Tie them up! Finished? That's good.
Abanaza, you'll have to forgive my son! He's always making these silly puns!
Where are you? Puns? Huh! I'm hungry. Wishy-washy. Yes, it's time to have your last meal. I shall send one turn. I shall give you some of her scones.
If we haven't already abscond it.
Save the line, yeah?
You'll have to forgive my son. He's always making this silly puns.
Correct, you got it right this time. Well done. Then I shall see that he is punished!
What should I do?
Use the lamp.
But I haven't got the lamp.
Does he mean the lamp I found in Abanaza's room?
My master says you'll be going to be executed.
Do you have a last wish?
His wish, he wants to meet with the emperor, princess, I mean.
Oh, why didn't you say?
Martine is here, isn't she? I came to rescue her. Could I see her before I die?
I think I can fix that. I'll go and get her. I should ask her to see Tingming. I hope she comes too.
It's too bad to come all this way without finding her desire. The object of your quest, I think, is meeting a princess or something like that.
Oh, there you come.
Aladdin! What are you doing here?
Wishy-washy, you are here too.
I came to rescue you. I'm sorry. I failed.
No, Aladdin, you haven't failed. You have won my heart. Oh, Aladdin, poor Aladdin. Whatever can I do for you in return?
Oh, if you have a free hand, perhaps you can give this lamp for
me. Are you afraid of the dark?
The lamp! At last, I have it in my hands. But now, I don't know what to do with it to make the magic work. What should I do with it? I rub the lamp with ghee.
Oh! Look, it's him, the great powerful genie of the lamp. I am the genie.
Don't you mean genie?
No, I am the genie of the lamp, the very bright lamp.
I thought you said he was enormous.
Wait till he stands up.
He's standing up.
Well, size is not important. It's what you do with it.
Genie, I wish you would free me.
Yes, your wish is my command.
Where is your command?
Aladdin!
Just help me, I'll tell everybody.
Aladdin, you're free!
I know that I'm free. Oh, it seems almost a pity to leave. I've become rather fond of this palace. I've had Atachi become to it. Could you just go? Whoosh! And take the whole palace back home.
Yes, your whoosh is my command.
Great, then we can all go home.
Where's your birds?
Majesty, the Emperor. Yes?
Yes.
Oh, who is that?
Hi, what?
Someone. I dropped on my bus and my boots in my
Your daughter. Father always can talk time, you know? I think he's just a lot. Okay, he's Emperor. Little Emperor. Your parents are so funny.
Okay, Empress, our daughter?
Our daughter has been kidnapped, oh my true of the Chinese people. How can a place go for the time like this?
I can't. Some proposal fired has placed on my foot in green.
Mother, father, I'm free! Aladdin has rescued me!
So this was your dream. You have to boil the knife for this.
No, it's not fair!
No, you're right.
I don't want to boil the knife.
No, you're right. I don't boil have a boil in
oil.
Chop into pieces.
No, you can't do that! I can't marry him if he's chopped up into little pieces!
She's right, you know. Marriage first, execution afterwards. That's what they always say.
That was before?
That was before Abanazi kidnapped me. But then I realized how horrid I was to Aladdin. I really did miss him.
You did?
I did. And now I want to marry you and live happily ever after. But you can't do that! You're the Emperor! All you need to say is he's a prince and he will be!
Oh, can I really? I must try it. You're a prince!
Woo! I'm going to marry a prince!
There is still the question of a dowry.
I'll settle for $100,000! Just write me a check!
No! You have to pay us! Whatever happened to those tasteful diamonds you brought to the palace?
Can the dowry wait? The evil was still on the loose.
Yes, that's why we need the genie. I wish we could catch a banana!
No! We don't need a genie! We need a policeman! No, the thing we should do is...
I wish you could...
Choo-choo! Thank goodness at last there is someone with a bit of common sense. There is a very dangerous man. You must arrest him at once.
Sola, I'm not allowed to arrest the Emperor.
Inspector! My magic lamp has been stolen!
Zuya has been set. Round up the usual suspects.
Thank you.
Abanaza, you deceitful, scheming villain! You froze me once, but you won't do it again!
Freeze you, you insolent, interfering imbecile! I'll incarcerate you in an eagle!
Eagle?
Igloo!
But I have got the lamp, Abanaza! Without it, you cannot lift a finger against me!
Don't hurt me! Don't hurt me!
Shall I do something nasty to him?
Yeah. Oh, no! Please don't hurt me!
You're nothing but a great big chicken!
That man kidnapped my daughter. He's certainly...
Whole kingdom.
Whole kingdom.
He should be punished.
Perhaps he can assist me at the laundry without imposing on the prince.
That's a splendid idea. Can you him want to be laundry assistant? He can help with wash.
Yes, he washes my command.
You know, I have a strange desire to go out and buy a bottle of fabric conditioner and an ironing board.
Excellent! I have an immediate vacancy for a laundry worker.
But I have no experience.
Don't worry. There is on-the-job training available. I'll tell you everything I know.
That shouldn't take long.
Oh.
Well, that's up another sorted out. And I've got everything I could wish for.
I always said that boy had no imagination.
Thinking about it, these genies are capable of causing a lot of trouble. I'm going to have one last wish. I wish that both the genies were free!
You've done it! At last I'm free. Now I can fulfill all my life's ambitions.
What's that?
I'm always to want to be a dancing queen. Come on, everybody, join me.
Yeah.
That's it. They've gone. At last, just only you and me.
Yes. It's I'll thank for being free.
I mean, I will miss a prisoner with their chain that treadmills mobile shops.
I'll think and I'll miss skeletons, cops, and coaches.
The police helped me. I'd like it. Thanks for Inspector Chu. The Tin Man brought a lot of glamour in Wishy-Washy's life, and the one ton waited in and there and added the strap.
Washing socks with Widow Twenky.
Aladdin and Martini are delighted with their life, and the princess have made the best of wives.
The big one, who is the camp, and the master of the master is left. But most of all, friends, we thank you for coming and cheer us, and hope you'll come to see our pantomime next year.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the pantomime. Have you all got one of these sheets? Describes a bit about what pantomime is all about. It's a traditional English occasion at Christmas time. Before I explain, I just want to say that if there is indeed an emergency, if you have to leave the theatre quickly, there's an evacuation point at the back. There's also one on this side here, and at the back of the theatre as well, behind the curtain. Okay, it's a fun event. We rely on a lot of interaction between the audience and the cast. It's supposed to be fun. You can join in. There are certain traditions we have in the theatre, in the pantomime. The main male part is played by a woman. The dame, which is a female part, is usually played by a man. But because we've got a shortage of players, we've got a woman playing a man, playing a woman.
Yay.
So it's very confusing. Okay. So in order to join in, when the villain comes on, you shout,
"Boo!"
Oh, come on, let's have a bit more enthusiasm. When the villain comes on, you shout,
"Boo!"
And again,
"Boo!"
Right. And when the hero comes on, Aladdin, you shout,
"Hooray!"
If you see any skeletons, if you see anybody creeping up behind people, then he's behind you. And if they ask you questions, "I'm going to be the best, the most powerful man in the world. Yes, I am." You say, "Oh, no, you're not. Oh, yes, I am. Oh, no, you're not." All right? Okay. One final thing. Unfortunately, one of our players couldn't attend today for other reasons, so you might well find one of the cast having to read from a script. I'm sorry about that, but never mind.
Boo!
Thank you. Enjoy.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people.
It is the emperor and empress.
Pray silence for the emperor's proclamation. The mighty ruler of the Chinese people has decreed a public holiday.
Hooray!
A short holiday!
Hooray!
There will be party at the palace.
Hooray! By your aunt invited.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that his only daughter, Princess Martine, is fabulous. He's come of age and will shortly get married.
But not to me.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that his only daughter, Princess Martine, can marry any man she chooses.
Provided he's fabulously rich.
The celebrations will last all week.
But we will have to clear up.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that the pubs will be open all day. But they won't sell beer.
They'll give it away.
Limited stock.
The mighty ruler of the Chinese people proclaims that there will be a parade of beautiful ladies in the streets of the city.
Ooh. Our fully closed!
Ooh. Hear the proclamation of the mighty ruler of the Chinese people and rejoice.
Walton! They're stopping all the traffic!
I don't know. I suppose they want another bridge across the river.
Another bridge across the river? That's a good idea. Walton, I'm nearly at my end of my search.
Oh, thank goodness for that. My kids are feeling me.
No, yet, not yet, Walton. There is no time to rest yet. I did not travel the world in order to rest. Think of the dreadful places we have been to.
The Renko Hotel.
The Renko Hotel, yes. I have found the whereabouts of a boy, an innocent boy. The innocent boy who can enter the forbidden cave. The boy who can obtain for me the lamp that will make me the most powerful man in the world.
What about me?
You? You've been no good wanton. You're not a boy. You are no longer innocent.
That's not what I mean. It's all the well you've been. The most powerful man in the world. What about me?
Wanton, you are expendable. This is the place. Kindly bruise your knuckles on that door.
Hello, what do you want?
Is this Widow Chanky Twanky, the Chinese laundry?
Yes, but we're close to be for stock taking. Who are you and what do you want?
I am Abanaza.
A banana?
Abanaza, Abanaza! I didn't travel halfway around the world to be insulted by a half-witted oaf with substance for brains.
No, who did you want to be insulted by?
I do not want to be insulted.
Who's your friend? I'm Wanton. You don't look that heavy.
No, she's what called Wanton because she's always getting in the soup. Yes, I want to talk to the washerwoman.
You want the washerwoman? Why didn't you say it? Mother, what is it? There's a man at the door says he's a banana.
Well, tell him to pull off and I'll be down in a minute.
Did you say mother? Widow Twanky is your mother? But you're not Aladdin?
Oh, no, I'm Wishiwashi. Aladdin is my little brother.
Ah, your little brother, I see. I did not realize that my brother had two sons.
Your brother?
Oh, I thought he was a banana. This one doesn't look at all fruity to me. Now get indoors and make yourself useful.
Madam, I'm afraid I've been rude to your esteemed elder son. I took him for someone who worked here.
Chance.
Yes, allow me to introduce yourself, myself in fact. I am Abanaza, the brother of your late husband.
Then how come I never met you?
From the earliest days of your courtship, I lived in a cell in a Tibetan monastery, engaged in deep studies of the mystic arts. And now I've returned to make the acquaintance of you and your delightful family. I am particularly interested in meeting your younger son, Aladdin.
Oh, don't be ridiculous! The boy hasn't done a stroke of work in his life. What could you want with a lazy lad like him?
A lazy lad like him, yeah. My mystical arts have revealed that he has hidden talents. Talents I can use to good and profitable effect.
Oh, profitable? There is money in it? Ah. But I couldn't possibly relieve the dear sweet boy. He's parted with the warp of the laundry.
It would not take long, and the boy would be well rewarded for his efforts.
No, no, I couldn't possibly entertain him leaving my side for a single minute. He's far too precious to me, not for the weir. I couldn't think of him going away, not for any reward. How long would it take?
It will take a matter of a couple of days to reach my goal.
Oh, 2 days deprived of my darling young son. I think my heart would break if he left me for that long. Tell me about the reward.
I see that money is of interest to you, my good woman.
No, it's not for me. It's for the benefit of my poor sons. I have saved up for a new washing machine.
Oh, why? What happened to your one?
Thieves broke and stole it!
Were these washing machine thieves caught?
Thieves and stole it! They made a clean getaway! Anyway, here I am, bereft of my tools of my trade. I desperately need money to finance a new washing machine.
Ah, esteemed sister-in-law, you are clearly a woman of the world. Now, know then that the quest I wish for your son to undertake will lead him to a cave filled with unimaginable riches. However, you and I know that money keeps the world turning.
I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Exactly.
And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me.
That's too bad. In my dreams,
rich man's world. Aha! It's a rich man's world.
It's a rich man's world. What is it, Mother? Sorry to interrupt your work. Could you go and fetch Aladdin and tell him to bring his toothbrush? He's in the bank room ironing the bank notes.
What's he doing in the clock?
We have a sign line laundering money.
Very funny.
Indeed. So this is your little brother.
You sent for me, Mother?
Yes. There is a very important person here to see you.
I am your uncle, Abenaza.
Oh, I'm delighted to meet you. Yeah. Your uncle has a difficult and dangerous job for you, which is going to make me rich. What I mean to say is your kind uncle will reward you for doing some simple work for him.
But I can't go away. There is a carnival going on in the city, and Wishy-Washy and I are going to join it. The princess is due to arrive back today. I wouldn't want to miss that for the world.
You can't go frolicking in the city when there is work to be done here. I shall cut you down with a firm hand.
But we want to swan around and enjoy ourselves. After all, it is a public holiday,
and that means there won't be any work to do here. You owe us this holiday, and we are going to take it. Now? Now!
Hey, he's getting away! After him, wanton! I need that boy! Where's he gone?
Where?
Where's he gone?
Where's he gone?
Where's he gone? Well, there should be a dragon coming on in a minute, but we'll wait for it. We'll talk about something else while it comes on, shall we?
Change the scene first.
I'll walk right in and chat her up.
That's all very well, but what will I say to her?
I'll offer to guide her around, show her the local sights,
the hanging gardens of Atrau Hotel.
Well, I'll improvise. I'm sure to think of something. Here they come. The problem is, how am I going to get her off? She has in Scotland's household cavalry, the finest gardens in the land.
easier to me. With a little help from my friends, I'll be loser.
Okay.
Excuse me, Your Highness. May I have the honor of escorting around the city?
That would be very kind of you. The household cavalry, the finest guardsmen in the land, seems to have been ambushed by a crafty regiment of double-ranging salesmen. Where are the good burgers of the city?
The really good burgers are at TGI Fridays.
Not that sort of burger. Don't you think it's the most horrid city?
Well, I kind of like it. I live here.
Here? But everything is so depressingly ugly. Oh, even the people. I'm used to beautiful clothes, beautiful building, and beautiful people. Where are the beautiful parts of this city? Where are the people who know about important things like clothes?
As a matter of fact, my family business deals with clothes.
Perfect! Then you can show me the area where you live.
I would be delighted. Please, step this way, Your Highness.
I think that has been a success. Aladdin has disappeared and so has the princess. Excuse me, have you seen my brother?
I'm sorry, I don't know your brother. Have you seen Princess Martini?
That's all right, I don't know Princess Martini either.
But she's the daughter of the Emperor, everybody knows her.
Oh, that Princess Martini. I think she's gone for a stroll with my brother Aladdin. Do you really know him?
Yes, I'm Ting Ming, your lady-in-waiting. I was following her through the city, but I got bored. And now I've lost her, and I feel so lonely.
You mean you live in the palace with the princess? That must be really grand. The most exotic place I ever visited was Anbar Supermarket. Where have you been with the princess?
Last year we went to India to Maharaja. He had a pool in the middle of his palace where all the ladies went swimming.
Why didn't the men go swimming?
Well, the Maharaja's elephants had run off with their trunks.
Well, tell me about the princess. What's she like?
Well, like a princess, someone who used to live in palaces, wearing beautiful clothes and having her own way.
You don't sound very happy.
Oh, it's so wonderful, but I don't have any real friends.
Is it really that bad?
Okay, let's go.
It's not fair! You're a rotten, deceitful fraud!
What did I do?
You told me your family were in closing business!
Well, we are. I just showed you my mother's shop.
But I thought you meant your family designed delightful dresses for debutantes. You must take me home at once.
Certainly, Your Royal Highness. Would you like to go straight to the palace, or shall we try to find the household cavalry?
Oh, I've forgotten about them. How jolly. They'll be looking out for me. Oh, Mother will be furious when she finds out they've lost me.
I could hide you in a wash basket.
You know, you're really quite resourceful. In fact, I could quite get to like you if you weren't a rotten, deceitful, good-for-nothing washer son of a filthy old washerwoman who I'm never going to speak to again.
Washerwoman, I look quite clean, and in any case, you haven't spoken to her yet. So it would be difficult never speaking to her again.
It's you I'm never going to speak to again.
Well, you're not making a very good job of it so far. It's this way to start.
I've sold all the soldiers, and the ladies in waiting are waiting in the ladies.
Did you remember the fanfare of the sergeant trumpets?
Trumpets? Oh, that was a team. You'd better send back all those trumpets.
You're totally incompetent! I can't see. I have to check the war organization myself. And you'll have to behave yourself at the ceremony.
But I always behave myself.
You always behave yourself badly. As the emperor, you're supposed to remain aloof.
But I shall be aloof. I'll be the most aloof person here. Nobody will be aloofer.
Stop, babbling! Don't touch drink and leave the ladies alone.
Yes, dear.
And stay off the chocolate jet. Oh, wait, you rule all the Chinese people.
She thinks I'm getting fat? Tell Nancy, do you think I'm getting fat?
No!
Oh, my dear rule all the Chinese people, how could it be that you believe the Empress is too beautiful, too wise, or too genius?
Oh, she nags a lot, but then it was her nagging that set me off from being a provincial prince and made me what I am today.
Hand-packed?
All right, hand-packed emperor. That was like this.
Spy on me, baby, you shine a light. You're ready to see me through the night. Ain't gonna fire, shoot me right. I'm gonna let the way you fight. But I you found the secret word I use to wash away my lonely
sex bomb, sex bomb. You're a sex bomb. And baby, you can turn me on.
He must be pursued and brought to justice.
Oh, I know where he lives. I can do that anytime.
Then I shall send the guards round right away.
But you can't do that.
Where is he?
Where does this rock dwell?
I'm not, Sally.
Tell me at once.
Shan't.
Why ever not? We must send the soldiers to fetch him.
But they'll be rude and nasty and pinch his arms. I don't want them to hurt him. He's really ever so sweet. Come on, Ting Ning, let's go and find Mother.
Princess has
beautiful arms. Unlike her mother, she had one glass at all, you know? We used to call her very flat. You know, when you and the Empress will stay, she's very flat, I know it.
Yeah, of course.
Me and you. So, the princess has had a beautiful complexion, you know? Like Spanish glitter. Oh, and like her mother at all.
Better skin on her rice pudding. I've seen better
skin. I've seen better looking eyes on a potato. As a matter of fact, she has one glass eye.
How did you find out about it?
Oh, it come out in conversation. Look, you know, the Empress holding an audience at the palace. They need to bring a gift to impress her. I intend to be there.
You?
Yes. I'm going to marry the princess.
But what do you give her? Why the old wash is very busy?
Mother, why you don't believe it me? I was hoping to impress you with my love for her. Then I shall go out and seek my fortune in the great wide world. Myself again.
In that case, perhaps you would care to reconsider my offer. Come with me, Aladdin, and your future will be secure.
Could we get back in time for the ceremony?
That may be possible. However, it is imperative that we start now.
I don't know. I don't like the idea of being away from
home. Oh, go on, you big sissy!
Should I go with him?
Yeah.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
It will ruin the story if he doesn't.
All
right. Mother, do you think I should go?
Aladdin, dear Aladdin, it will break my heart to see you go. You are so very precious to me. I don't know how I would manage with you going away from home. Have you got a toothbrush?
Yes.
Come, Aladdin. Come, Wanton. It's time we hit the road.
Huh. What do you want to hit him for? It never did you any harm. Goodbye, Mother. Goodbye, wishy-washy. See you soon. Bye.
Bye.
You know what Father said? I remember that Father said he was an only child. Yes, he was. He had no brothers or sisters to play with. But if he was an only child, how can Abanaza be his brother?
What do you mean, boo?
Boo!
This is the place! This, Aladdin, is where you must do your work!
I said we can't escape, but this is just a stonewall!
Nevertheless, this is the place! You forget my magic, Walton! This is the entrance to the cave, but it is shut! To open it, we need only say the magic word.
Which?
Open Sesame! Your job, Aladdin, is to go into this cave.
But I don't want to go into the cave. It's dark, creepy, and full of horrible hideous things!
In the cave, there is a lamp!
Wouldn't it be better to take a lamp into the cave?
It looks like an ordinary lamp, but it is standing on a pedestal surrounded by dazzling jewels and ancient stones.
Like this dragon.
Mick Jagger.
That wasn't even funny. Anyway, okay. Your job is to find that lamp and bring it back here to me.
But I don't want to go into the cave.
Aren't you coming
with me?
Alas, no. This is a magic cave. It can only be entered by someone young and innocent. I am far too old, and Monton is...
Just old.
Right, it comes down to a simple question, dear Aladdin. Which are you afraid of, that cave or me?
But why I should be afraid of you? You are my uncle.
If you don't go in, I shall give you reason to be afraid of me. Remember that I have studied the mystic arts. My spells are deadly. Still, I shall see you come to no harm in the cave. Here, take this. It is a magic ring. It will protect you. And now into the cave and get me the lamp. Mind the spider.
Lost in here, you could wander around in circles for hours, and it's so creepy. Something moved? I'm sure something moved. Did you see anything move?
No.
You did see something?
No.
There, what was it?
Skeletons.
Skeletons.
Bones.
Back there?
Yeah, behind you.
Are you sure something moved?
Yes! Yes.
Well, if it happens again, tell me where it is.
Yes.
No, there is nothing moving. I told you. You're imagining things. It's this creepy cave. Just a few minutes down here, and you start imagining skeletons. You're not so scary. You want to dance and sing?
Forever.
But he can bring the lamp
out. No, Anton. This is part of the spell of the cave. If he carries the lamp out, he will be his. He must hand the lamp to me.
then I shall seal him in the cave for eternity.
They're going to shoot me. What can I do? I have to persuade them to let me out. Uncle Ebenezer! Uncle Ebenezer, give me your hand. You'll have to pull me out.
Pass me the lamp. Then I'll pull you out.
No, the lamp is too heavy to pass to you. You'll need to pull me up.
Nonsense, boy. Just give me the lamp.
Shall I give him the lamp?
No. Yes.
You shan't have it till I'm out of the cave.
If you don't give me the lamp, you'll never get out of the cave.
But you don't want to let me out if I do give you the lamp. I heard what you said to Wonton.
You shouldn't listen to people's other people's conversations. You clearly got the wrong idea. Now give me the lamp.
Why are you being so mean to me? Uncles are supposed to be kind.
I am not your uncle, you stupid boy. Now give me the lamp.
Never.
Then I'll shut you in the cave. You'll never escape.
That's what you think.
This is your last chance, boy. Will you give me the lamp?
Never! You rotten, dishonest, scheming, evil villain! And you're not even my uncle!
Then I shall seal you in the cave forever! Shut, Sesame!
I'm shutting. But escape should be easy. All I have to do to get out is to say the magic word. Now, what was it? Can you remember?
Open Sesame!
That's it! The rock should have opened, but it didn't work. Perhaps you can't work the magic. I'll try it. Open Sesame! Open Sesame! Nothing happened. I'm trapped! Trapped in this cave forever! It's no good. I've been wandering around here for hours. And there is no way out. I'm stuck in here with only horrible operations for company. What can I do? Perhaps the skeletons could help me. No, that's no good. If they knew the way out, they'd have got off while they were still alive. What's this? Oh, it's the ring Ebenezer gave me. He said it was magic. What should I do with it to make the magic work?
Run the ring!
Hey, it's getting hot. It's nearly burning my finger.
Oh, hello. You look like a nice boy.
Who are you?
You don't know? Don't you recognize the cultured manner? The exquisite cut of these clothes, the manicured nails, the air of mystery and magic.
You are Barack Obama's wife?
Oh, you don't recognize me.
No, sorry, who are you?
I'm hurt, I'm grieved, I miss it.
Who is he? He's what? Him? Nah, he isn't.
Yes, he is.
Oh, no, he isn't.
Oh, yes.
He is?
Yes.
Are you a genie?
You do recognize me? That's right. I'm a genie of the ring.
But genies are huge and muscular.
Well, not all of us. Some of us quite delicate. Anyway, your wish is my command.
What do you mean? Do you really have unlimited powers? Can I wish for anything I want?
Well, not unlimited. For a start, I can give you only 3 wishes. The great powerful genie of the lamp could grant you 2 unlimited number of the wishes.
But all I need to do is to wish for you to fetch me the genie of the lamp, and I can have anything I want!
No, that's against the rules. I can't tell you about the genie of the lamp, but I can take you to him, and I can fetch him to you. The lamp is hidden in a dark forbidden, rather like this one. It's standing on a pedestal surrounded by jewels, rather like this one. It can be obtained by an innocent boy, rather like you. It's looking just like an old brass lamp, rather like on your holding. That's it.
This lamp contains the most powerful genie in the world. That's why Ebenezer was so keen to get his hands on it.
Pet it away quick. You might disturb the genie. He's huge. He's hideous. He's horrible.
Oh,
dear. I wish you would get me out of this cave.
That's that easy. Why didn't you say? All you have to do is go back the way you come.
But Abanaz has shut the entrance.
All you have to do is to say the magic words.
I tried to open sesame, but it didn't work.
Open sesame, it's to get you in. Getting out is the reverse to going in. So all you have to do is to say the reverse open sesame.
Which is?
Emesis Nepo. Try it.
Emesis Nepo. What happened?
Try it with a bit more conviction.
Emesis Nepo!
We are going to need a helping hand. Will you give him a hand?
Yes.
No?
Yes.
Yes, that's right. The magic words are Emesis Nepo. Say it, count on three. 1, 2, 3.
Emesis Nepo!
The earth moved for me too.
Today, Amanet is called for princess. Mustache.
Mustache?
Yes, mustache.
What do you know? I don't know.
It's him!
It's who?
It's me!
It's you? Shall we go?
Now's the time!
Here they come!
So let's scram!
Stop thief! Stop thief! Inspector! Inspector, do you know where I might find that boy? The one that caused all this trouble? It is very important that I find him. He's somewhere in this crowd.
This crowd? How unlikely, Ganaiskins, you all look the same to me.
His name is Aladdin.
And his mother is Widow Twenty.
Ah, yes, Lange boy. He said his mother was Florence Nightingale.
Florence Nightingale?
Yes, he said he was looking for the lady with the lamp.
The lamp wanton. Widow Twenty has it. If we're quick, I can turn this to my advantage.
New
lamps for old.
I say peddler.
I say prophet. Might I offer you a fine new lamp in exchange for an old lamp? Do you by any chance have an old lamp for sale?
Well, I do have an old lamp, but it's very valuable, a family heirloom. I'm not sure that I could be to part with it.
Might I see it? Do you by any chance have this lamp with you?
As a matter of fact, I have. It's so precious to me that I never let it out of my sight. It's a very valuable lamp. It has a hallmark on it.
Well, let me see. Let me see. Ah, here's the hallmark. Oh, yes, it says Attardale Museum.
Well, I should exchange for this.
Ah, here you are. Oh. Take this new lamp home where I'm sure you will be enlightened.
What a strange man!
Ah, Twenty.
Ah, Choo!
Bless you. I met your sons in the town today. They were looking for you and the strange man was chasing after Aladdin.
That boy is always being chased by a strange man. I can't think why.
I must destroy this crowd. Move you along. Move you along. Move you along.
Mother, I found you at last. Have you seen Aladdin?
What are you doing here, you disobedient lazy boy? You were supposed to be at home, finishing my day's work.
We came to look for you. Aladdin wanted his lamp back. Now I lost him.
Stupid boy! I suppose now we should find Aladdin while you're going to find your brother.
Then you still got the lamp?
Yes! Well, no! I still got a lamp! The previous puss! This was purchased by a passing peddler!
Oof. What did he give for the 30-year-old lamp?
He gave me a 30-new lamp!
What are you for?
Oh!
What?
That man, he pinched my bottom!
Hey, you! Come back my mother's bottom!
Stupid boy!
Mother, it's nearly time for a ceremony at the palace. I need a gift to impress the princess, something romantic, to show her my undying love. But what can I give to a girl who has everything?
Try exquisite food!
I'll go and get you some. I left some sandwiches in my room a couple of weeks ago. I knew they would come in handy.
Stupid boy! He'll never impress her! With all the sandwiches, she has not yet got those from her mother! Now, what I want if I were an eligible young girl? A diamond!
A kiss of the hand, baby. Quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat, or help you at the automat. Men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these rocks don't lose their.
Better, Shashlik. You need something with a bit more wow and a little less fear.
Oh, I wish you could make me fit to visit the palace.
A spot of dressmaking, just up my street. Come with me, young man.
right to rule all the Chinese people. Get on your throne this minute!
Of course, dear. The first tutor is Marcus of Polo.
He'll never take my breath away.
He must be worth a minute.
Next!
The next suitor is Oil Sheikh, who made his fortune selling dairy products.
Oh, a milkshake?
What did you say your name was?
I said Sheikh Yabuti.
From an oil shake.
Next!
I bumped into a banana outside.
How odd! Most people sleep on them!
No, it was a statement to be chasing Aladdin.
A banana?
Yes, him. He's coming this way.
Before he sees you, it's your turn next!
The next tutor is this is young gentleman. Your Majesties, may I present Aladdin?
You not right to be here! You're just a washerwoman's son! I'm not going to marry you! I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful.
He's a great husband for you.
Go away! I never want to see you again!
Chinese people. No gift could ever match the beauty of your daughter. I feel ashamed to bring such feeble riches into her presence. Nevertheless, behold, I present you with diamonds in the hope of winning her hand.
If I were you, I have a second thought.
He does look rather dishy and his diamonds are lovely.
Perhaps you could marry him first, then have him bought in oil. That was I did with my first husband.
Shut up. Make way for the mighty Abanaza.
What do you mean by best electus?
I bring you the wealth of the glittering caves, O midgety ruler of the Chinese people.
What's that in jewels?
And what's another face?
Have a care, my sweet Martini. I am the greatest sorcerer the world has ever seen. Your insolence could get you into trouble.
Leave it here alone, Abanaza. You deceived for scheming villain.
But I have brought the greatest gift. I have won the hand of the princess. I intend to take her away with me.
I shall stop you if I can, Abanaza. You won't get her away if I have anything to do with it.
Then you won't have anything to do with it. Not even your frozen stiff.
You can't do that.
Oh, can't I? Who's going to stop me, oh 6-inch ruler of the Chinese people, when I can freeze you all? I thought. Come, my dear, I'll take you away to my palace.
No!
I'm coming too. I must rescue Ting Ming.
Right, let's go. Mother, we'll need the lamp. Where is it?
This lamp? No, no. The one I got from the cave. The one I was after.
That old lamp. I met a peddler who was swapping new lamps for old. So I got this in exchange for it. If you ask me, it was a bargain.
If you ask me, you've been burnt, so I don't really see how. The peddler. It must have been Abanazar. That's how he got all those Jews. And that's how he gained the power to freeze me. He's got the lamp. I must find Martini right now.
Personally, I could do with a steam vodka.
Mother, stop the time. The prince is in terrible danger. We must find him right now.
Where are you going to look?
Oh, no. I hadn't thought of that. What shall I do?
Rock the ring.
What shall I do?
The ring.
I'll have to summon the genie.
Well, in this case, a great big fairy.
It's getting hot again.
Wish number three. You were going to set me free, remember? It's not far. Nobody ever grant me the wishes. I'm going to go off and sock.
I'm sorry, Genie, but this is an emergency. Abanaz, get out the princess!
Oh.
Empty ring! And the diamonds!
Oh, Abanaz got control of the genie of the lamp?
Could you rescue them?
My princess!
Could you rescue them?
Oh, Abanaz got control of the genie of the lamp?
How do you know about it? I haven't said it to you. Yes, he's got the lamp!
Why didn't you say it? That's dreadful.
Could you rescue them? Well, we don't know where they've gone.
Oh, that's dead easy. Abanaz got a palace on the edge of the Gobite desert.
How do we get there?
Most people go by camel.
I'm not going by camel! They always give me the hump!
I've got to get there fast, but how can I get there and set you free?
It's impossible, but never mind. Getting the lamp away from Abanaz, that's far more important.
But you haven't solved the transfer problem yet!
The great powerful genie of the lamp could whisk you a magic carpet to fly all the way to Abanaz's palace.
And you can't do that? I wish you could get me the princess, but how can I get there? But how will you get me there?
Taxi! Take him to Abanaz's palace. Oh, and watch out for the stairs. Well, you can't say I didn't warn them.
But what about me? I do have a quest. I want those jewels back.
Well, what do you expect me to do about it? Thank you.
visit Abanazi's palace. Did you give the cabinets a tip?
Yes, I told them to watch out of the stairs.
That was a waste. I wonder where Aladdin's got to. I'm surprised we didn't lose him earlier in the dash to get here. We followed him all over the place.
Now what do we do? We've got to find where Timing and Princess Martini are buying health.
Well, I expect we're being locked up with other valuable things like those diamonds. If we start by looking for them with a bit of luck, we'll find them as well.
And if we find the diamonds, we don't find the girls?
Then we steal the diamonds for consolation. Wishy-washy, do you get the feeling we're being watched?
Well, there are some signs of life there.
No! I meant back there! Something moved!
You've been overdoing it. You're beginning to imagine things.
Did something move?
Where? Oh, no, I didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
Come on, wishy-washy! Wishy-washy, do you get the feeling we're being locked up?
That's the trouble with having a professional mother. Even when you go away, she brings work with her.
No, I didn't bring it! It's my worst nightmare! I've been watched by unwashed socks!
What shall we do?
Well, personally, I'm going to do my Olympic sprint impression!
Of Athanasis.
Where are we?
Some sort of hall. It's the place of entertaining crowds of people.
Well, that will have to wait till later. I can hear voices from behind this wall, and there is a window to the next room.
Well, sneak a peek.
I can't see. I could do with a couple of extra inches.
If one of the things on my master have bishop for.
I think there is someone coming this way. It's time to stop it.
To normal as soon as we're married, my pretty princess.
But I'm not going to marry you. You're old and ugly. I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful.
Well, so your other four isn't bad. We'll get married as soon as the priest has a free Saturday.
Get Fersen to marry you. The Emperor of Jack. You can't defy the mighty rule of Chinese people.
The mighty tape measure of the Chinese people will do what I tell it. You forget, insolent Ting Ming, and I am the most powerful sorcerer the world has ever known. Have a care, I will turn you into a beetle.
Oh, I always miss Paul McCartney.
Well, I'm not going to marry you. I shan't. Shan't.
We'll see, my petulant princess. Perhaps a spell in the dungeons will soften them up. Guard! Take him away!
Banaza, what do you want to do? The manicure anyway.
Well, aside from the insolent trivia, she's just such a stunning good looks. If I marry her, I will automatically inherit the Chinese Empire when her father dies, which he will very soon. So with the Emperor in the bag, I can turn my attention to the rest of the world!
It's ridiculous. All you want to do is build your own little palace all over the place.
I want power, Wonton. I intend to be the most powerful man in the world. Oh, yes, I will. Oh, yes, I will.
Well, isn't fair. Well, you should use it. This princess has accumulated all this power. What's in it for me?
The pleasure of witnessing my rise to the top.
Why should that give me any pleasure?
Well, I've told you before, Wanton. It's because we are friends.
Huh. Why should we be friends? You have a lot of things to help you. You haven't ever done to help me.
But I've never needed you. You're so resourceful, Wanton. But if there comes a time when you need me, I'll be there. This way,
and as far as I'm concerned, I'm glad I got a chance to say that I do believe I love you, and if I should ever go away, well, to close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. If you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure, that's what friends are for good times and bad times. I'll be on your side forever.
Now then, Wanton, I have a crucial job for you. I want you to instigate a search of the palace.
Oh, you lost your false teeth?
False teeth, woman? Yeah. No, Wanton, I want you to search for intruders.
Intruders?
Yes, Wanton, I feel there are spies abroad. It is the most important that we protect the princess. Guard her well. With your life, if necessary. I shall retire to my room for a bit of intense thinking. I always think better lying down.
Where are we? No idea. I've lost my beings completely. Wolves have ears. Right, you try that way, I'll try this. Well, I never thought that I'd do this at my age. I didn't find any diamonds, but look. I did find Aladdin's lamp. We'd better get away from here before Abanaz wakes up again.
Was Abanaz there?
Yes, he was lying on his bed surrounded by very tempting bottles of champagne.
And you couldn't resist the temptation?
Quite right. I picked up an exquisite magnum of champagne. I hit him over the head with it.
Soul of discretion. Why are you looking for intruders?
I've another thing. They'll be looking for Prince Martini. But I doubt so.
Why he's so worried? But he's locked up in the dungeon, and he's got the key.
Have you looking down that way?
Hmm?
Yeah, that way.
Aye?
I spotted some sage characters there earlier on.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. I go and check.
Psst, Aladdin. The princess is in the dungeon. And all we got to do is to got the keys.
Right, where is it?
Abanaz's got it.
Oh, well, that should be easy then.
You forget my magical prowess. I am still good for a short spells. Walk this way.
From the vegetable car at Ardagir.
Perhaps he will defrost and come and rescue.
He couldn't possibly. He's just a washerwoman's son. Rescuing princesses is reserved for noble, honorable, rich young men. It's a shame that Abanazar has froze his assets.
Would you like to marry Ardi?
Certainly not. He's a poor weakling. I only want to marry someone who's young and handsome and rich and powerful.
Well, 2 out of 4 is a bet.
You may be right. And I'd rather settle for Alvin's than Abanazar's. I really shouldn't have been so mean to him. He'd be a fool to want to rescue me after the way I treated him.
I'm sure Alvin won't forget you, not after what he said at court.
Why are you so cheerful, Ting Ming? We're stuck in this dump forever. Nobody's going to come and rescue us, so it's not use talking as if they are.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to keep our spirits up.
Ting Ming, I'm sorry. I really am. I'm so dreadful for people all the time. It's because I'm used to everyone doing what I tell them. But now, it's different. Now I need friends. And I really need help.
most terrible headache. It seems to emanate from this lump on my head. I can't think how it got there. I know champagne goes to my head, but it doesn't often leave lumps there. Now then, I must decide what to do with the princess. I have a hunch. Ah, it's you!
Oh, so it is.
But, if you're here, that miserable wretch Alani must be here too. Take him, Nita, take me to him. I have him in my power.
He's around there.
Where? Where? Hey, where are you going? I'll go by one.
I think we've lost him.
And there still goes again.
Aladdin! There you are! Thank goodness you are here! I have palpitation just thinking what that nasty Abanas may do if he falls in the palace! Thank goodness you are safe! Where are they?
They're in the dungeons.
Why does he keep the diamonds in the dungeons?
Not the diamonds, the girls! We've got the keys! We wanna wait to rescue them!
Oh! If you must, the dungeons are just down here!
But look out for Abanas, he was following behind us.
Boys! I want to see something!
Just group around and see what you can find.
It's abstract! It's abysmal! It's abandoned! It's abnormal! It's absurd! It's abominable! It's Abanas!
How delightful! And you have the keys to my dungeons too! How convenient! I have you in my power! This time, you are doomed!
I've escaped from you once, and I'll do it again!
Escape from here? You have more chance of escaping from La Cabana Bar! Guards! Tie them up! Come on,
Aladdin, I have something you wanted.
Not now, Mother. I'm a bit tied up at the moment.
Tomorrow, I shall feed you to my crocodiles. What do you say about that?
I'm hungry.
Yes, it's high time you had your last meal. I shall send one turn. She'll give you some of her scones.
You should forgive my son. He's always making the silly puns.
Then I'll see that he is punished!
What shall I do?
Use the lamp!
I haven't got the lamp!
Does he mean the lamp I found in Abanaga's palace?
Mother says you'll be going to be executed. Do you have a last wish?
Yes, he wants to meet with the princess.
Why? What didn't you say?
Martina is here, isn't she? We came to rescue her. Could I see her before I die?
I think I can't fix that. I go and get her. I should ask her to sit in me. I hope she comes too.
It's too bad to come all this way without finding her desire. The object of your quest, I guess. I want to see the diamonds also.
Aladdin! What are you doing here?
Wishy-washy.
You are here too.
Oh, I came to rescue you. I'm sorry, Ben.
No! You have succeeded! Oh, Aladdin, poor Aladdin. Whatever can I do for you, Nita?
Oh, if you have a free hand, perhaps you could give this lamp for him.
Why? Are you afraid of the dark?
No.
The lamp! I've got it at last. But now, I have my hands on it. I don't know what to do with it. What shall I do? What shall I do?
Look out! I am a genius.
Don't you mean genie?
No, I am a genius of the lamp. It's a very bright lamp.
I thought you said he was enormous.
Wait till he stands up.
He's standing up.
Well, that is not important. It's what you do with it.
Genie, I wish you would free me.
Yush is my command.
Oh, Aladdin, you're free.
Oh, not tell another. He'll be terribly cross. I shan't say a word to him. It seems almost a pity to leave. I've become rather fond of this palace. Yes, personally, I have become attached to it. Can't you just go? Whoosh! And take the whole palace back home.
Yes, you whoosh is my command.
Whoosh, who is there?
Who is what?
Someone got the palace departed from my boots.
Our daughter has been kidnapped, O mighty ruler of the Chinese people. How can a player play a golf at a time like this?
I can't. Some proposed fire has placed in the path of my boots.
Mother! Father! I'm free! Aladdin has rescued me!
So this was your dream. I'll have you boiled in oil for this.
But you can't do that!
No, you're right. Boiling in oil is too good for him. I'll have him chopped up into little pieces.
No! It's not fair! I can't marry him if he's chopped up into little pieces!
She's right, you know. Marriage first, execution afterwards. That's what they always say.
It was before Abanazi kidnapped me. But then I realized how horrid I was to him. I really did miss him.
You did?
I did. And now I want to marry you and live happily.
Suspects.
those people called. That is the man you should arrest, Abanata. You deceitful, scheming villain. You froze me once, but you won't do it again.
Free you, you insolent, interfering imbecile. I'll incarcerate you in an igloo.
They have got the lamp, Abanata. Without it, you cannot lift a finger against me.
Nasty to me!
Shall I do something nasty to him?
Yes. No! No, no!
You're nothing but a great big chicken!
This man kidnapped my daughter. He threatened the whole kingdom. He must be punished.
Perhaps you can assist me at the laundry with Aladdin posing as a prince! That's a splendid idea. Can you make him want to be a laundry assistant? He could help with the wash.
Yes, your wash is my command.
Why are you laughing?
I know. I have a strange desire to go out and buy a bottle of fabric conditioner and a new ironing board.
Excellent. I have an immediate vacancy for a laundry worker.
But I have no experience.
Oh, don't worry. There is on the job training available. I'll tell you everything I know. That shouldn't take long.
Ooh.
Well, that's how Banaza sorted out, and I've got everything I could wish for. Oh, I always said that boy had no imagination. I'd wish it for a diamond tiara and the gold lame blows. Thinking about it, these genies are capable of causing an awful lot of trouble. I'm going to have one last wish. I wish that the pasta genies were free!
You've done it. At last I'm free. I can fulfill all my life's ambitions.
What's that?
I always want to be a dancing queen. Come on, everybody, join in.
Yeah.
Kingdom. We're all alone. There's only you and me.
I wish to see them all again with being free.
I'll miss it, the presence with their chains, the transmit mobile shops.
I'll thank for traders, skeletons, dragons and bobs.
Always help me. I'd like it. Thanks for Inspector Chu.
I'm saying for Emperor and Empress.
Martini, I'd like it with their life.
Jingming
brought a lot of glamour with him, which was his life. And one toss waited him, and Jeff, and the other struck.
We have another Delta Nestis. He's with his Twinkies, washing socks now.
Aladdin and Martini, I'm delighted with their life, and the princess has made the best of life.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to say a thanks, as we, as one normally does at Oscar ceremonies, to everybody. But I wanted particularly to thank our sponsors, Ajip YKK Training Centre and Scott Global Safety Clothing Supplier, just to sort of compliment the backstage people, as well as all the people who've made costumes. Gail Hughes made a huge sacrifice. She wasn't able to be here, but she's in England now enjoying it, so we really need to thank her for all her efforts. Ludmilla, for allowing us in here. And again, all the backup people. We've got the prompt. Carol. Prompt. Rita. The O'Connor family who made the O'Connor family who made the dragon. Scenery, sound, lighting effects. Andrew Gill up there. Tom Christie, Bill McLeod, Mark Lingani and all the heavy mob from my team back in Aggie. Where are they? Finally, I want to make a little presentation to all the players.
Oh, yes, sorry. Mr. Bob here.
Yes.
Can I take some words? Okay, so on behalf of our training center, I also want to thank all your team, which made so magnificent, so fantastic performance today. First of all, I want to tell the same to you, Mr. Bob. You are a great actor. You are perfect, Mr. You are so young, but you're so experienced. We are very proud of your skills. Thank you, guys. We really enjoyed your performance. Thank you.
Okay. I'll give a diploma to every all the cast now. Sebastian. Shusha. She's in.
Shusha.
No, she's not here. Dina.
Dina's
not here. No. Lisa. Yeah. Danielle's not here. Masha! Nisa!
Nisa!
Aymur!
Maddy!
Shina! This is the one I get to
kiss.
Marina! Anwar Ivan. Jana Chikova. Bhaktia Zakirov. Anwar Jamanayov. Tatiana Costolina. Azura Sanizieva! Leila Kaidorieva! Janat Daigorieva!
Thank you.
And then okay, picture.
Bob, sorry. And one present for special present for our Bob Hill. Please, can you take for a very long memory about this land? And one moment, we invite all assistants who helped to this performance, please come to here. For getting the presents, a little presents for you. Please just here for the stage.
Everybody there?
Yeah.
Yes. Sound guy?
Yes.
Are we here? Big smiles. I'm gonna take four more pictures.
Yeah.
Four. All right. Four.
One. Two.
And one.